Hey everyone, I'm here to dive deep into the world of RAID configurations, a critical topic for all you IT professionals out there. Let's unlock the secrets of RAID 0, 1, 5, 6, 10, 50, and 60, and find out which setup might be the best for your systems. First off, RAID 0. This is all about speed and performance. By striping data across multiple disks, it offers superior read and write speeds. However, keep in mind, there's no redundancy here. If one drive fails, you lose data. Next, RAID 1. Think of this as your data mirror. Whatever you write to one disk is mirrored to another, providing high redundancy. The downside? It's not as space efficient as RAID 0. You'll only get the capacity of one drive, but if a drive fails, you're safe. Moving on to RAID 5, one of the most popular choices, it offers a good balance of speed and security. Data and parity information are striped across three or more disks. If a drive fails, you can rebuild the data using the parity info. However, rebuild times can be lengthy, and performance can degrade during this process. Now let's talk about RAID 6. Similar to RAID 5, RAID 6 includes an additional parity block, providing even higher fault tolerance. It requires a minimum of 4 disks and can tolerate up to 2 disk failures. However, it has a higher write penalty due to the extra parity calculations. RAID 10 combines the methods of RAID 1 and RAID 0. It mirrors and stripes data across multiple disks, providing high redundancy and improved performance. Perfect for databases and high availability applications. But remember, it requires at least 4 disks, so it's more expensive. For larger networks, RAID 50 and RAID 60 come into play. RAID 50 combines strips of RAID 5 arrays and offers better performance and error recovery. RAID 60, on the other hand, is a stripe over multiple RAID 6 arrays, providing even higher fault tolerance and capacity, suitable for large-scale operations. So, there you have it. Each RAID level has its own pros and cons depending on what you prioritize: speed, security, or storage efficiency. Whether you're setting up a server or upgrading your storage solutions, choosing the right RAID configuration can significantly impact your system's performance and reliability. Thanks for tuning in, and I hope this clears up some of the mysteries surrounding RAID configurations. Make sure to consider your specific needs and the criticality of the data you're managing before making a decision. Catch you in the next one.